know that lactose intolerance is fairly common and affects about 75% of the global population? Yes, you heard that right. And how does it actually occur? Well, it occurs due to the absence of lactase, a digestive enzyme that facilitates the breakdown of lactose, which is the main carbohydrate found in dairy products, into glucose and galactose. And this results in several digestive issues that can create a negative impact on a person's life. Yes, you heard that right. Hello, I'm Resham and you're watching DNP Health. Firstly, welcome back to our channel. So in today's segment, let's discuss everything about lactose intolerance and clear all the facts related to it. So first off, let's discuss to what are the symptoms of lactose intolerance. So some of the symptoms of lactose intolerance include diarrhea, nausea, vomiting, as well as bloating. They may appear within or after 30 minutes of consumption of foods containing lactose, and if these symptoms occur repeatedly and cause trouble, like a lot of trouble, it is best to see a doctor as soon as possible, ASAP, as they will walk you through the risk factors and suggest other calcium-rich foods or supplements as substitutes as well. Not only that, do you know that there are three types of lactose intolerance? Where first is the primary lactose intolerance, which is the most common type that happens due to aging. Then is the secondary lactose intolerance, and this occurs when the small intestine decreases the production of lactase after an injury or might be with an illness. And the third and the next is the cognitical or development lactose intolerance, and this refers to a disorder where infants are unable to break down lactose in formula or breast milk, and this is usually hereditary. So as we discuss about the symptoms as well as the type, now let's talk about if there are any ways to prevent lactose intolerance. So let me tell you that presently there are actually no ways to induce the production of lactase in the body. The straightforward treatment is abstaining or completely terminating the intake of milk. Yes, you heard that right. But you can still consume milk varieties that are lactose free. Further, not all dairy products have high lactose content, so those too can be an option. Also, avoid cheese, butter, yogurt, etc., as they are derived from milk. And well, I get this a lot of times, that what actually are the lactose-free dietary sources? People really want to know that. So let me tell you that for lactose intolerant people, the safest option is a diet free of that molecule. Yes, again saying that. And don't worry, a lactose-free diet isn't devoid of zesty food. In fact, fruits, vegetables, beans and seeds including pineapple, mangoes, berries, broccoli, carrots, zucchini, eggs, sunflower seeds, flax seeds, chia seeds, barley, wheat, etc. actually fit in that category. Yes, and other lactose-free dietary sources include beef, lamb, chicken, soy foods and nuts as well. So that was all for today's segment, and all about lactose and lactose intolerance and the ways, the types, the symptoms, everything. So that was all for today's segment in a detailed way. If you like today's content and video, then please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to DNP Health. You can also follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Keep loving us, keep showering your love, stay safe and keep watching DNP Health.